Welcome to third video of career guidance. In this video, the course that will be there after 10th is the stream would be commerce. Then after 12th, what are the possible career paths that are there and what careers they will choose, so they can choose. Let us see that. So the career paths that are been discussed in this video are financial planning, business administration, chartered accountancy, company secretary, cost and management accountant, banking, marketing and computer applications. These career paths are been discussed, and if you have any questions, please ask in the comment section. We'll try to answer as much as possible. Now I'll tell you about commerce combination. The stream is commerce, right? It is next to science, and most of the students in this commerce, right, those who wish to pursue the business or want to go into insurance sector or banking sector, they take this commerce stream. And in this there are different combination. The combinations possible are these, right? So economics, business studies and accountancy, these three subjects are very much essential for the commerce and trade. And along with that, there will be a fourth subject. The fourth subject could be computer science or statistics or business mathematics, business maths. So these are the possibilities. If you take this, then you will be getting having the combination CEBA, M for MEBA, M is business mathematics and SEBA. These three are really good combinations. Among them, MEBA and SEBA are the really good combinations for the students who would like to pursue their career as a chartered accountant or a company secretary, CA or CME, right? So these two are very, very important combinations if you want to pursue your career there. Or if you find this computer science, statistics or business studies, normally those students who feel these three as the different difficult subjects, they go for political science, that is PEBA, right? So political science, economics, business studies, accountancy or HEBA, right? Of course, P and H combinations with EBA may not suit well for the commerce stream, right? But some of the students who feel mathematics is a bit difficult and computer science and statistics difficult, they go for this. And if you want to score more, right, more 100% marks, then better combination is MSBA, mathematics, basic maths, statistics, business studies and accountancy. So in this we can score 100 out of 100. One of my student has scored 400 out of 400 and got third position to the Karnataka state, and next to the third rank rather. Then other combination which can score more is CSBA, computer science and statistics, business studies and accountancy. These two are the combination which are the scoring subjects. So and then let me come to CEBA combinations, right? So if C is computer science, E is economics, B is business studies and A is accountancy. If you take this as a combination in 11th and 12th, that is first PUC and second PUC, after 12th you can take up BCA as an undergraduate combinations, undergraduate course. The BCA, that is Bachelor of Computer Applications, right? So here if you want to pursue your career in IT sector, that is as a software engineer or other cloud computer, a computing expert or engineer or data scientist, this is the one, the data scientists are in demand now. So if you want to pursue this, right, if you want to opt for this career, then choose BCA, that is Bachelor of Computer Applications. So if you take this, right, then your job would be software development or app development or operation executive. In most of the cases, the people with the BCA degree end up as an operation executive, and most of the people who have taken who have been appointed in IT sector as an operation executive feels that this is somewhat an underperforming job, and most of the people express that this is not a job for them. And normally what they do is, instead of to avoid this, they do the master's course, that is MCA, after BCA. And once they do that MCA, then they can demand more and they can be a software developer or app developer, and they could be a wonderful software engineers in the IT sector, right? That's what the people have expressed as their opinion, that you can see it in the next slide. So this is the combination for the commerce graduate with CEBA as the combination, right? If you take CEBA as the combination, the BCA is the best option for them, so that they can be a very good software developers or app developers, right? This is one of the best course. The salary varies from 1 to 2 lakh, and again it depends upon the industries. It will be more also, that details can be seen in the next slide. Now let us see the additional information for BCA and also the noted personalities who are in the computer application field. The BCA graduates, right, the job prospects, right, what are those, that you can see it from this job portal for the BCA graduates. and also even Infosys will also appoint BCA graduates, right? Those informations can also be obtained from this, right? And then and what are the other institutes or organizations which will appoint BCA graduates, and even these also tell about how the Infosys appoint this, what are the requirement and the recruitment processes, career as prospects at Infosys can be obtained from this. And then some of the companies, other companies which will hire BCA graduates have been explained here by the people who are being placed by the other agencies. And also some people have expressed a displeasure over their perform their role there at this company. And most of the people say that the office ex what is that executive post that they are having, operation executives, right, is not good for their career prospects, right? So what they say is even that is also been discussed in this web portal, right? They have shared their peer reviews, right? And then they say that it is not just BCA is sufficient, it is better to do MCA for the higher prospects and also better bargaining power in terms of the work. So that they can do application development and software development rather than just a process and looking after operations and then finding the strategies, right? Just strategies and reporting to the higher upper management, right? So that's what most of the people felt, and they feel that MCA is better prospects, right? And the reputation of the year during the hiring process, what matters is reputation of the institution is most important also. That makes the difference in making the bargain in terms of position as well as the salary. So that matters, and also from and how many things, how much of a salary that you can expect after a BCA that you can get it here. But the best thing is do MCA and get into the better for prospects jobs. And along with that, most of the people in the Quora have shared their opinion that it is whatever they study in the BCA or MCA is not sufficient. It is better to do additional courses and take the challenges, freelancing, challenges like freelancing, hacker hurt, and this is this will pose the challenges every day, right? Answer those so that you will be well versed with it, that you can get more information and you can rectify your mistakes and get more knowledge on it. Along with that, artificial intelligence and machine learning. So these are all the additional course if you have done, that will be more useful. Then the question that arises is, you may be asking, right, who are the noted personalities who have done computer applications? Of course, this gentleman has not done bachelor of computer application, but he is a MCA graduate from the Trichy, NIT Trichy, right? He is Natarajan Chandrasekhar. He is a CEO and MD of Tata Consultancy Services, right? He is MCA from NIT Trichy, right? So this is one feather for the students who are doing BCA. They can claim BCA, MCA rather, right? So, and other courses, as I mentioned, ACARARC, and the challenges could be seen every day. And if you answer that, then also you can be noted. And getting noticed by the organization for the company is also important. This is one such means. And other suggestions being made by Bill Gates, Zuckerberg, etc. So there are the courses on JavaScript, right? That they are all free courses that can also be learned for coding purpose, right? And with the BCA graduates, what are the other courses, additional courses that can take up has been given in this link. So please utilize this opportunity and be a better software developer or application developer, and though you are from a commerce background. So this is one of the best opportunity for you. Now let us go to the premier courses of commerce stream. In this, after 10th, if you have taken any of these combinations, CBA, BBA, CBA, PBA, HBA, MSBA, CBA, you are eligible for this, but I prefer MEBA and SEBA are the most suitable for this premier courses. And those courses are Chartered Accountancy. This is after 12th examination. You have to take a foundation course, CA foundation examination, and once you clear that CA foundation, you will be registering with the Institute of Chartered Accountancy of India, right? So after that, you will be having three levels, right? One is earlier CA foundation used to be called as a CPT, now it is called as a CA foundation, and after that, the next level used to be called as IPCC, now it is called as CA intermediate. Then after CA intermediate, will be having CA articleship, and after that will be 3 years with the chartered accountant, and the last 6 months you have a CA final. So once you clear that, you will be registering as a chartered accountant with IC. You will be registering as chartered accountant. And what you do is you will be a tax. You can be a tax consultant, an auditor, an advisor, and a financial officer in any major industry. So normally the CA will be the people, the person who will be next to the owner of the company, right? So you'll plan and advise the company about its prospects, and also financial aspects of it will be taken care by this chartered accountant, right? So you could be a tax consultant also, you will be an legalized auditor. So the signature of a chartered accountant is important for any auditing aspects of any company. So you can be a chartered accountant. This is a premier course for the commerce graduates, right? After 12th you can register for a CA foundation, and after clearing that, right, you can become a member of this, and then you have three levels, and then if you pass, then it will be, you will be a chartered accountant. Remember, the success rate is not very high. It is about 2%, right? So, and even the CA foundation is also about 16%, right? That is the success rate in the examination, right? So it is quite tough, and for that the combination MEBA or SEBA are the best options, right? And the salary, and of course it varies, it will be from 6 to 9 lakh, and it can go up to crores, right? That is the first course. Next is the company secretary CS. So right, so here this is again a three level course, foundation, intermediate, and of course it is it will be called by a different name, right? Okay, there are again the three level courses, right? So here this person, right, the company secretary will be responsible for all the regulatory compliances of the company and act as an in-house legal expert to the company. He is the person who will call the meeting of the board, and they will execute whatever the board decisions which are there, and will be the responsible person to register or to communicate with the SEBI, Stock Exchange of India, right? And he is the most important person in the company, right? So, and he is basically a legal expert, he knows a legal expert to the company. And his salary varies from 3 to 10 lakh, the person's salary varies from 3 to 10 lakh. So that is the another premier course, right? Next is cost and management accountant, CMA. And here also this is what CMA intermediate, sorry, foundation, intermediate, and final, right? This again has a three level, right? And these are all the course you can immediately register after second PUC, that is 12th grade. And here the role of the CMA gentleman is, the person with the CMA is certified cost accountant, maintains the cost accounting records, do cost accounting auditing, helps in planning, controlling, and costing of the products. It is, he is basically business strategy, you will build the business strategies for the company, and all create the value creation for the company. So he is the most important person in the industry, right? So this is again the registration by, this is not a regular classroom courses, right? So you will be taking up along with your graduation, or separately you can do it after 12th grade, right? So these are the three important premier courses for the commerce graduates. So more details could be seen in the next slide, right? So CA, chartered accountancy, accountant, company secretary, CMA, cost and management accountant. These are the three important premier positions which most of the commerce graduates aspire to become. Now I'll tell you about the additional information regarding the most premier courses of for the commerce graduates, right? The first is chartered accountant. For that website is ICAI, that is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and this you can get the information on the CA foundation, registration for the CA foundation, and thereafter can be obtained from this. And there are five successful chartered accountants, right? The details of them can be seen. Those five, let us see five, those five successful chartered accountants. The first one is Kumar Mangalam Birla of Birla Group of Industries, right? So Aditya Birla Group of Industries is a well-known successful industrialist, right? He is also a chartered accountant, a successful chartered accountant. The next gentleman is T.N. Manoharan. He was a chairman of Canara Bank, and also he is the person who is responsible for restructuring the fraud laden Satyam Computers, right? What were the fraud that has been done, right? When has to be nullified, and in the sense that has to be restructured, that is, it was Falling Down, that was restructured by this CTN and Manoharan. So, and he is also president of ICAI. And then Naina Lal Kidwai is the first woman to be graduated from Harvard School, right? She was also president of FICCI. And then this gentleman Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, he has been considered as Warren Buffett of India, and he is a investment guru. Right, the people look for his suggestions while investing in stock market. And Motilal Oswal is another investment expert. Right, these are all the five successful chartered accounts. It doesn't mean that we have only five. There are many, many chartered accountants for businessmen, industrialists, politicians, advisors to the many political parties as well as the industries. Now let us see the company secretaries, right? So this the career on this can be known from this link, and then this is the website for the this is the Institute of our Company Secretaries of India, right? And here you will get to know about the CS course, that is company secretary course. What are the three different levels of it can be obtained from this? And here the most sought after job is the company secretary, and that can be known from this, right? And then this YouTube link will tell you about more about this company secretary, so you can listen to it. And then there is another one of the best CS articleships firms in India, right? That can be known from this blog. And this will tell you about the important factors building the success of a successful company secretary career, right? So what are the best possible factors that can help to become a very good company secretary, right? This link will tell you about that. So next comes the CMA, right? Cost and Management Accountant, right? So that details, the course details can be obtained from this, right? From the foundation to the final stage, right? Together three stages could be obtained from that. And this is the web portal of Institute for Cost and Accountants India, right? Cost and Management Accountants India. And then the student's website, the career prospects for this CMA could be obtained from this, right? And then this will tell you about the average salary for the CMA graduate in India, right? And then this YouTube link will tell more about the CMA. There is another YouTube which will also tell about the CMA. You can go through it. And then this will tell you about what if you do CA, CS or CMA, what will be that, right? That analytical approach is there in this link. You can go through it, and also you can come to know this salary part, right, by another person expressed in Quora. Now let us see other important courses for the commerce graduate. See, after 10th, if you have chosen commerce as a stream, and with these combinations, then you can opt for CF, that is Certified Financial Planner, given by FPSB, that is Financial Planner Standards Board of India, right? And this is in consultation with FPSB of USA, which is there in Denver. Will confer this certification program, will the certificate to the person who fulfill the academic requirement, education and examination, the stringent examination conducted by this board, and on the basis of that results, the certifications will be issued. And this certificate is recognized in more than 23 countries all across the globe. And this career will be certified financial planner, and your job would be careers in areas of personal finance, wealth management, insurance planning, mutual fund investment. So you basically financial planning is involved in it, and it's really one of the best course for the students who won't want to pursue in finance sector. The salary varies from 3 to 7 lakh, right? This is one of the best course, and it's a certification program after 12th grade, right? You can start off with this, right? There are many organizations which are recognized by FPSB boards of India, and with that you can take up this examination, and really good for the people who would like to pursue their career in financial sector. Next is BBA, that is Bachelor of Business Administration. It's also called as Bachelor of so in some university they call it as Bachelor of Management Studies, BMS, right? And here the careers involved are HR, Human Resource Management, HR Manager, Manager, Marketing Manager, Business Development Manager, Supply Chain Manager. So these are all the career paths for the graduates of a BBA, Bachelor of Business Administration. The job of this BBA graduates would be a good understanding of managerial practices and concepts, can guide to explore ample opportunities in the business world, inculcate leadership and managerial skills. It is more about the management aspects, it's more about human resource management, it is basically administration oriented course, right? So those you will be having the leadership and the managerial skills inculcated with the BBA degree, right? So this is basically the Bachelor of Business Administration. And if you do the masters, that will become, so that will be MBA, and most of the students who do this BBA will obviously go for MBA. So MBA has more weightage than the BBA, right? Of course, even with BBA you can think about the salary of 2.5 to 3.5 lakh per annum. The next most important combination, the course is Bachelor of Commerce, BCom. So this is the invariable choice for the most of the commerce graduates who are pursuing either CAF or CA or CS or CMA, right? So this is the basic course that normally students will do this, and those who complete this bachelor program, right, this after 12th you take BCom, that is undergraduate course, and after completing your career could be in banking, marketing, business analyst and auditor, and even the event manager. You can become event manager, right? So job is the work would be ledger maintenance, bookkeeping, communication of this, and the logical thinking for the company, right? So basically it is more related to the accounts management and in the company, right? So this is the basic degree for the commerce, and the salary would be between 1.5 to 4 lakh, right? And if the experience, if the person is more experienced, then obviously the salary will go in all this field, right? The salary will go up as the experience increases, is more. And compared to BBA and BCom, there is a wonderful comparison, right, that you can see it in the next slide. There is a link for that. So here, this is for the most, for the BBA is mainly for the administration, whereas BCom is for the finance and account related aspects, right? So this is more of a financial aspects, business and trade, and this is more of administration. Here is a slide of most successful BCom graduates, Bhavin Turakia and Divyank Turakia, and these people have started this company called media.net. when Divyank Turakia, when he was of a 14 year age, he started his internet business, first internet business, and at the age of 18 he earned $1 million, and at the age of 23 he earned 100 he has become 100 million dollar owner, and now he has crossed $1 billion at the age of 34. When these gentlemen have sold his company, that is media.net, to a Chinese company, Michano, right, for $900 million, of $1 million, of $900 million. So there was the beauty of these two boys, right, and basically they are the commerce graduate. But one interesting thing is, though they are commerce graduate, they have taken up that to become just to pass the time, but most of the time they were doing work on writing the codes for the internet businesses, right? It is basically advertisement company. So what they do is that they develop the products for the advertisers as well as the publishers, providing them with an entire suite of services, including creating, targeting and evaluating advertising campaigns, as well as the connecting publishers through their Yahoo Bing network. So it is just more like a networking, right, that they used to do, and with that they have earned quite a lot, right, and they have been cited in Forbes magazine also. So these are the examples for our main inspirations for the students who would like to pursue their career in commerce field. Now let us see some more information regarding this certified financial planner and BBA and BCom, right? So this is the web portal for the financial planner certification. So this is fpsb.org of Indian company, that organization rather, and with this you have to register, and that will of course they have the recognized educators, and through them you can register and get the financial plan, right? And more information can be obtained in this, right? This is for the US financial planner link, right? And then this is about the same data financial planners in the different countries, right? And here this will come to know how do you become a certified financial planner, the details of becoming the certified financial planner from the beginning. You can get the details about it and where it has been recognized. You can be known from this. This link will tell you about how you can become a certified financial planner. This link clearly explained. And pay scale for the people who are having this financial planner certification, what is the average salary for them, that could be obtained from this link. Right, this will give you the detailed information regarding that, and how much can the fresher in India can earn. You know that this SIF financial planner is recognized in 23 countries, right? So how much they can be earn in India can be known from this, right? And here a Bachelor of Business Administration, this is for the business administration, and your salary and what are the career aspects that could be seen here, right? The details is available in this link. Then BBA, the careers, what are the different careers which are there, and this further link which will tell you about the different options which are there and after the BBA, that is be a Bachelor of Business Administration, and what are the career possibilities, that is other options, right? So with this you can make a plan about the BBA course, and then career options after BBA, what are there, so MBA or whatever the things that you can get it from it. So normally most of the students who do BBA will go for MBA, right? And the BBA scope and what is the salary for the people who with the BBA degree can be obtained from this, and then this will tell you the comparison of a BBA and a BMS, right? So that is Bachelor of Management Studies, right? Some universities give the BBA as BMS, right? So there is a slight difference. That difference can be seen in this slide, right? So most of the student, as I mentioned, they do MBA after BBA, that is most suitable for the students would like to pursue in administration. For the BCom, right, so what are the career options after the BCom that you can be obtained from here, and then what are the career options, again this the discussions which has been done by a person who has been a become graduate and who is there in that career, right, has explained here, and then what is the average salary for the BCom graduate that will be obtained from here, right. Next is scope and salary for the BCom graduate is here in this link. So with this, these links will give the additional informations for the financial planner to the administration or the financial expert or people who would like to pursue their career in BCom. Hi friends, I hope you like this video, and the information provided here will be sufficient for you to make the career in the field which are specified. And the next video will be on arts, right? So before that, please like this video and share with your friends. The next video is on what career paths are there after 12th and or second PUC if arts stream is taken after 10th. So this is the title of the video, so please type this in the search space and get this video. And here it's not only for arts students, even for the commerce students who are interested in tours and travel management, hotel management, career in hotel management, design, law, and also journalism, right? So this these careers does not restrict itself to any of the combinations or stream that you are taken in the 11th and 12th. It could be taken up by either arts or science or commerce. That is there in the next video, that is part 4 of the career guidance. Part 5 is also having a career which can be taken easily by the commerce students. Hope this will be more useful for your career growth, and please do like my video, my channel, and also subscribe to my channel by hitting this thumb button, right? So please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Have a great career.